Hi, this is Kannababu from Satcha Technologies. Today we all are here to learn WCF. Web Services WCF will play the major role at the time of application development. So let us see what is this Web Services or WCF. First of all, we must know about one concept called homogeneous application. What is homogeneous application? Is it clear? Creating the communication between different applications, creating the communication between different applications that was developed by using same languages or same technologies. The type of applications are called as homogeneous applications. Two different applications will communicate with each other. All of you, please stop your videos. Please pause your videos or stop your videos. So creating the communication between different applications that was developed in same languages or same technologies are called as homogeneous applications. Heterogeneous application means creating the communication that was developed. Creating the communication between different applications that was developed by using different languages or different technologies. The type of applications are called as heterogeneous applications. So first of all, before going to this web services or WCF, you must have the knowledge on some basics like what is web application? What is web application? The application that was deployed, on web server. And it can be accessible via browser and internet. The type of applications are called as web applications. And these web applications are basically divided into two types. One is static web application, other one is dynamic web application. Static web application means what? Static web application means the application whose output is common. The type of application is called as, static web applications. Example for static web applications, you can take W3 schools. Is it clear? Similarly, you can take some blogs or movie review websites. This all comes under static web applications. Is it clear? The application whose output is common for all the users, that type of application is called as static web application. Mostly, static web applications can be developed. By using UI technologies. UI technologies means like HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. Similarly, coming to dynamic web application. Static web application means the application whose output is common for all the users. That type of application is called as static web application. Next, dynamic web application. The application whose output will change. Is it clear? Whose output will change based on user or location or time or such. That type of applications are called as dynamic web application. From one user to another user, the output will change. Is it clear? If you open Gmail, if I log into Gmail with my username and password, I can see my mails. If you log in with your username and password, you can see your mails. From one user to another user, the output will change. If you open Facebook, if I log into Facebook with my username and password, I can see my friends list. If you log in with your username and password, you can see your friends list. From one user to another user, the content will change. That is dynamic web application. Similarly, if you open IRCTC, based on my search, I can see the train details. Based on your search, you can see the train details. From user to user, based on search also, the data will change. That is dynamic web application. Similarly, if you take Swiggy, If I order any food in Swiggy, I can see the restaurants near to my location. If you order any food in Swiggy, you can see the restaurants near to your location. Based on location also, the content will change. That type of application is called as dynamic web application. Dynamic web applications can be developed. Similarly, Google News you can take. Google News, for every time period, the news will change. That is also dynamic web application. Dynamic web applications can be developed by using server-side technologies. Server-side technologies and frameworks like if you're a .NET developer, you can develop by using ASP.NET or ASP.NET MVC or ASP.NET Core. Similarly, Java people, they can develop by using servlets, JSP, Spring. Python students, they can develop by using Django, Flask. Or you can develop dynamic web applications by using nowadays MeanStack as well as MernStack. Also, you can develop the dynamic web applications. Mean means, M represents MongoDB, E represents Express.js, A represents Angular, N represents Node.js. Similarly, MernStack developer means what? In place of Angular, you must have the knowledge on React.js. So these are the technologies that are available in the market to develop dynamic web applications. So you can develop dynamic web applications by using Java, .NET, PHP, Python, etc. Did you understand, everyone? So let us see. So generally, let us see the architecture of web application. If you want to develop any web application, you must have the knowledge on programming languages, as well as technologies, as well as frameworks, is it clear? Database softwares, these all are required actually. Programming languages, as a .NET developer, you must have the knowledge on C#.NET as well as TypeScript also. If you want to become a full stack developer, TypeScript is also required. Technologies like ASP.NET is required to develop web applications. ADO.NET is also a database related technology. Frameworks like ASP.NET MVC, it is a framework. ASP.NET Core, similarly, Entity Framework, it is advanced framework for ADO.NET. And database softwares, mostly .NET developers will use. Okay. And we'll use the support of some frameworks like WCF as well as WebAPI. These two are also frameworks. Database softwares like SQL Server. These all are required to become a full stack developer. And Angular also required as a full stack developer. Angular is added only, you're called as a full stack developer. Okay. So generally, whenever we develop any web application is what? Multi-user application. Multiple users can interact with single application at a time. That type of application is called as web application. Web application is multi-user application. So multiple users can communicate with single application at a time. That type of application is called as web application. So whenever we developed any web application, after developing the web application, what we have to do? We have to deploy the web application on web server. Whenever we develop any web application, we have to deploy that web application on web server. It is a common place where everyone can access. This is your server. If you take some application like bookmyshow.com, bookmyshow.com is there. So bookmyshow.com is a web application. So who will interact with this application? Bookmyshow.com is a web application. So who will interact with this application means I can tell something like the admin will be there. Similarly, the customer will be there. Similarly, the theaters will be there. These all are the different modules that are available. Okay, now the customer of the admin of the BookMyShow, what he will do? He will add the details like the theaters details. He will add the BookMyShow admin, that one. Okay, he will add the theater details, capacity details, and all the other stuff. The customer of the movies, the customer of the movies, he will select the seats, he will book the ticket, he will book the ticket, he will get the printout, he will do the payment. These are the responsibilities of customer of Book My Show. And the theater owner, what he will do, he will add the, he will add. So this bookmyshow.com is a web application. Is it clear? This web application requires one database. Let us assume here I have one database is there. Database means the place where the data is saved permanently. The place where the data is saved permanently in the form of tables, which is a collection of rows and columns. Like movie table is there, something like some booking table is there, something like some cancellation table is there, something like some accounts table is there. Okay, something like a lot of tables are there. These all tables belong to your database. Now let us assume this bookmyshow.com web application is developed by EC. Okay. So first of all, now how, who will interact with this particular application means end user. End user will communicate with this application via browser or internet. Through, he will communicate with this particular application. Is it clear? So now multiple users will communicate with single application at a time. That is the beautiness of web application. So this is your web application actually. Now web application, if you consider any web application, every web application will communicate with what? Every web application maximum, the purpose of web application is to do business. Business means what? Where the money transfer is there. That is called as what? Business. Is it clear? Business means where the money transfer is there. That is called as business. Are you following? So if you want to do the, if you want to transfer the money, is it clear? Definitely we need to communicate with some banking servers. If you want to transfer the money, definitely you need to take the support of what? Banking servers. Yes or no? So definitely, like I say, so who will do this business means the customer. Customer of the bank will do what? Business. Did you understood? He will try to do the business by using debit card or credit card. So definitely, banking people, they will try to support. They will try to support to the... Is it clear? So what these banking people will do, they'll create some services. Let us assume this is my ICICI bank. ICICI bank, what they will do, they'll create some services called as web services or some WCF services they will try to create. Are you following? And this service can be developed either by using Java or .NET or Python or PHP, whatever it may be. Is it clear? So these banking people must provide services to all their customers. Banking people must, this course is related to WCF, okay? So if you want to develop any web application, after developing the web application, you have to deploy the web application on the server. And your web application will communicate with database. This is BookMyShow database. Okay, now this database will perform what? Communicate with this database to perform different operations. Customer will search the movie details, book the tickets, cancel the tickets, and all the other stuff. And this web application must communicate with what? Banking application. So what banking people will do? Banking people also will have their own what? Database. Let us assume ICICI Bank is there. Now ICICI Bank must provide services to their customers. Who are the customers? The customers of the ICICI banks are nothing but end user. And these end users will interact with different applications like Amazon, like bookmyshow.com. Any application you take, every application will do business. Business means what? Where the money transfer is there, that is called as business. Now, what these banking people will do, they will create some services. They will create some web services. And these web services will be consumed by web application. So you all are web application developers. You are developing the web application by using Java, .NET, PHP, Django, etc. Now your application must communicate with this services to do the payment transactions. Mostly for the payment transactions point of view. Okay, now some PayPal services will be there. Is it clear? Every web application, that is very, very, very important. So as a developer, you're a web application developer, you're developing web application, and your application must communicate with what? These services. So that is the reason you must also have the knowledge on web services. Are you following, everyone? Can you hear my voice? Is it clear? Every web application developer must communicate with what? These web services. Is it clear? So first of all, you must know here, let us see. If I'm developing one web application, after developing this web application, is it clear? This application can be consumed. Let us assume this is bookmyshow.com. Bookmyshow.com is a web application. Similarly, here you have some Amazon is there. Amazon is a web application. Similarly, Flipkart, these all are web application. These all applications wants to communicate with banking server. Let us assume this is ICICI Bank. So what ICICI Bank will do? ICICI Bank will create one web service. And they will keep that service on the server. Let us assume this is your web service. And this web service can be and consumed by n number of web applications. Some thousands of web applications are existing, and these all web applications must communicate with consume what? Services provided by ICICI Bank. Okay, na? So web service is a third party application which will provide services to the web application to access the third party databases. Because your bookmyshow.com, you don't have permission to directly communicate with ICICI Bank database. So these banking people, what they will do? They'll create some services, and these services must be consumed by web application developer. So who will develop the web application? Developer. Who will create the web service? Developer. Who will interact with web application? End user. Who will consume this web service? Web application developer. So as a developer, your job is to develop the web application, and sometimes you must be able to consume these services provided by some third party. So you no need to create the service. If you get the job in any product based companies, you may get the chance to create the service. But initially, you must know how to consume this particular services. And the beautiness of these web services is it can be developed in any language, any technology. For example, this web application is developed in Java, and this API is developed by using .NET. Still, it will work. Okay, now back end, this web service can be created in any language or any technology, and web application was developed in any technology or any framework, but still they both can communicate with each other. It understood. So initially, as a developer, you must have the knowledge on this web services. Did you understand, everyone? Similarly, you can take some Google Pay. Any web application want to transfer the money through Google Pay, Google Pay will create one web service, and that service can be consumed by a number of web application developers. You all are web application developers. You must know how to consume the services. But nowadays, there is a demand for full stack developer. In olden days, total web application is developed by using what? Java.NET, etc. But nowadays, is it clear? Nowadays, here you can see you must have the knowledge on full stack developer. Full stack developer means you must have the knowledge on front end application plus back end application plus one database. Front end application is Angular nowadays. Back end application is Web API. First, we'll learn web services, WCF services. Later, we'll discuss about Web APIs. Is it clear? It will a common logic, it will provide services to multiple client applications. Your application may be a mobile application which was developed by using Xamarin Forms or Android, or it may be developed by using Angular, or it may be developed by using MVC, ASP.NET and MVC, but still all these applications can consume the services. All of you, please stop your videos. Anyone have any doubt, you can unmute and you can speak. You can ask the questions, I'll clarify your doubts. Is it clear? Web application is multi-user application. Multiple users can communicate with single application at a time. Is it clear? And these web services are basically divided into two types. One is soap services, other one is restful services. These web services are basically divided into two types. One is soap services, other one is restful services. Soap full form is Simple Object Access Protocol. Simple Object Access Protocol. REST full form is Representation State Transfer. Representation State Transfer. Okay, now you can develop the SOAP services by using WCF. RESTful services can be developed by using Web API. Web services are basically divided into two types, SOAP services and RESTful services. SOAP services can be developed by using a framework, that is WCF. RESTful services is an architecture, representation state transfer. It can be developed by using Web API. So both are frameworks. WCF is a framework, Windows Communication Foundation. Full form of WCF is Windows Communication Foundation. So what is WCF? WCF is a framework which is used to develop SOAP services. And what is Web API? Web API is a framework which is used to develop the RESTful services. Today's there is a very mandatory topic is Web API. Okay, now this class is for WCF. Later we'll discuss Web API. Can you hear my voice, everyone? Can you hear my voice? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Are you following the classes, everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. There are two frameworks are there. One is WCF, other one is Web API. So what skills are required to learn WCF means basic OOPs is enough.
The group of applications are the application sharing the information to public.
Sorry?
Public. As well as it is taking the data from the public also. Vice versa communication. User sending the data, server sending the data. User receiving the data and server receiving the data. So it's a dynamic
application. But sharing the application is a one-way traffic. This WCF services will always give the output as data, not design. Is it clear? Here, web application is there here. This is your web application. This is your what? Database is there. Let us say. What is the difference between this web application, web services? Don't confuse. This is your browser. See, this is your browser. This is your application, front-end application. This is your back-end application. Otherwise, you consider this is your application. This is your database. This is your web application. Okay, now web application consists of what? Files. These files are again divided into two types, code related files and data related files. Code related files are .html files, .aspx files, .jsp, .php, etc. Okay, now so this is browser. So browser will send the request to what? Server. Server will send a response to what? Browser. Server will communicate with what? Database. Get the data. Database, the query will get executed. Okay. So browser will send the request to server. Server will send the response to browser. The response what the browser is getting, that is in the form of HTML. Server will always send the response in the form of HTML. Sometimes it will send that response in the form of data. The data may be text, or it may be XML, or it may be JSON. Is it clear? This is what. See, web application will always give what type of output? It may give HTML or data. The data may be in text format or XML format or JSON format. In database, the data will be stored in the form of tables, which is collection of rows and columns. Now, how your web application will communicate with the database? By using database technologies, Aerio.net, or by using Entity Framework. Okay, now. And in Aerio.net, you have to pass the query to the database server. This database server will execute the query and send the result to web server. And the result is converted into some text or XML or JSON and sent to the browser. So what I mean to say here is, web application will give HTML output to the browser. But coming to web service, now 100% your web application must communicate with web service to do the payment transactions. because web application, that is example for web application server. You can take bookmyshow.com. Is it clear? Or you can take some IRC snail, movie websites, or any application you take where the customer is doing business, purchasing any items through online, then definitely web services is required. Now this is a service provider. Service provider is who? ICICI Bank. So service provider will create what? Web service. Service provider will create web service. Web service is also nothing but a class. It is concept what methods. In that methods, these web services can be created either by using Java or .NET, whatever it may be. Either Java or .NET, we can create some web services. Okay, C sharp. Okay, and it will communicate with this database. Okay, now this is your ICICI Bank database. Now your web application will communicate. Now this application is in one server. Your web service is in another server. Server to server communication is required. Your web application is kept in one server. After deploying, why to keep the application on server? Global accessibility. The entire world must be able to access that application. If the entire world want to access that application, we have to keep the application in the common place where everyone can access. That is nothing but what? Web server. IIS. .NET web server most will call as IIS. And if it is a, if web service is developed in Java, keep that application some Apache server. Now server to server communication is required. And the data transfer, server to server in middle some network is there. Via internet, we need to transfer the data between the network. Then we have to take the support of XML. In olden days, XML is very popular. Nowadays, JSON. SOAP services will use XML. RESTful services will use support both XML and JSON. Is it clear? So web application, you're developing one web application, keep that application on the server, end users. Now, web service will always give the output what? Either XML or JSON. What is the use of XML? Extensible markup language. XML is a universal markup language. It's a platform independent, language independent, technology independent, OS independent, database independent. Any language can understand XML. Any technology can understand. Any framework can understand. XML main purpose is to transfer the data via network. Okay, but XML is very heavyweight component. Some conversions are required, serialization, deserialization. Okay, now nowadays JSON is very, very popular. JavaScript object notation. It is a lightweight compared with XML. Mobiles can easily access the data from JSON. So this is the old style where the web application development is involved. Is it clear, everyone? So that's what I'm telling here. Now you can ask your doubts. If you have any doubts up to here, you can ask me. I'll clarify. Are you following, everyone? Okay, I'll clarify all your doubts. You don't. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. You can unmute and you can speak now. But one by one, you can speak. Oh, yeah. I'll give clarity. Can you speak loud? Server to server communication. What is required means data transfer is required. In middle. Sorry? One by one you can speak, please. It will disturb the total class. One person you can speak. Who is speaking? Your name?
Khalid speaking.
Yeah, your name?
Khalid.
Yeah, tell me.
Just I have to ask. This is, it means suppose if I provide some services for customers. So for this case, I have to use web services, right?
Yep, obviously. For example, you develop one web application, let us assume. You're developing one bookmyshow.com web application. The purpose of that application is what? Customers will communicate with that application and they will book the movie tickets through online. So definitely customer will do the payment through what? Using debit card or credit card. but your application don't have the access to communicate with the banking servers. Okay, your application is, you don't have permissions to directly communicate with banking people. So what the banking servers will do, they will create some services called as web services. And you're a web application developer. Your company will purchase that service, and they will, that service was given to the web application developer. As a developer, you must know how to consume that particular service within your particular application.
Yeah, suppose
it doesn't mean that only for banking. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. Suppose now, if I take the gateway from the bank in order to my site to reserve.
That is only. If you take any gateway, payment gateway to your site, means indirectly you are consuming the web service. Okay. This is old style actually. In old style, what happened? We use these web services only for third party. In order to consume the third party services only, we use it. But nowadays, the style is totally changed. Microservices came. Nowadays, within the application also, you are creating what? Web services. Is it clear? Five years back, what happened means, this is the style of consuming these web services. A separate developer will create the service, and a web application developer will consume this service. This is the old style. But nowadays, what happened, you know, full stack is dominating in the market. Full stack developers. In olden days, in full stack developer, what happens? Content application is there.
You want to learn how JavaScript knowledge.
Yeah, yeah. You can ask. Wait, I will unmute. One person you can unmute. Yeah, it is better. Voice is not clear. Yeah, tell me. Your name? Your name? Ajay? Anyone want to ask any doubt? You can ask me.
Oh, hello, sir. Hello, sir. Sarada. Yes, sir. Sarada, just want to know, are we going to discuss about REST? Because in interviews, they're always focusing on REST architecture.
Yep.
Web service and this one, WCF difference. I'm your old student. 4 years back, I learned from you and working in MNC, sir. Thanks for that. All that support.
Okay, great. Thank you. See, what I'm telling here is, first, actually, we are concentrating on WCF after completing. This is the batch name itself is WCF, right? Later, I will try to cover Web API also. Okay, first 1 week like that, we'll cover, concentrate on WCF. After that, we'll cover Web API. But the architecture is different. Coding environment is different. Everything is different. Compare with WCF and what? Web API. Is it nowadays what happened? As you told that Web API is hot cake in the market. So definitely every front-end application will communicate with what APIs. What I mean to say here is, in olden days, WCF is used only like a third-party application. But nowadays, this web services became the part of your web application. Third-party is there and web application is also there. Because nowadays, front-end application is required, back-end application is required. Front-end application is Angular or Android or iOS or Xamarin Forms or ASP.NET and MVC. Now, that is the reason people are writing some database-related logic and business logic in Web APIs. And what is the advantage of creating Web APIs within your application means multiple clients can communicate with this particular API. No need to write the repetition of code is not required. So within the application also, what came? Web API came. Entity framework means it is related to ADO.NET, ORM, Object Relation Mapping. Entity framework means related to ORM. Okay, that we'll see later. Did you understand the theme of the story, everyone? What I'm telling here?
Yes, sir.
Our main target, as a developer, you must know how to read the web services. For that, you must have the knowledge on XML. So I will slowly start with XML, SOAP serialization, binary serialization, some XML serialization, deserialization. Okay, how to transfer the data, how to create the services, how to consume the services, architecture, structure, everything. And nowadays, there is a demand for full stack developer. Full stack developer means you must have the knowledge on what? Angular, mandatory, plus Web API, mandatory. Plus NDT framework or ADO.NET. Is it clear? ADO.NET plus some ASP.NET MVC skills or .NET core skills, because ASP.NET is almost outdated. Now compare all the ASP.NET projects are converting into MVC or .NET core. Okay. So that is the reason. If you add Angular to your particular skill set only, you are called as a full stack developer. Obviously, C sharp skills are required plus SQL skills are required. So I'm starting Angular new batch, that is Wednesday, day after tomorrow. Is it clear? We are starting Angular new batch. Day after tomorrow, Wednesday, MVC new batch at morning 8:30 a.m. and Angular new batch at 10:30 a.m. Is it clear? And we are providing the flexibility. If you want MVC with Angular, 6,000 is the course fees. MVC Web API with Angular. Or if you want .NET Core with Angular, some 7,000 is the course fees. Only Angular, 5,000 is the course fees. We are giving an offer, special offer, because of Satya Technologies completed 20 years of successful anniversary. We are giving some offer to you. Is it clear? So Angular is hot. When you learn Angular, your Angular will communicate with Web API. That is hot cake in the market. This is what front-end application is Angular, back-end application is Web API, data transfer is by using JSON, communication Angular with Web API is by using AJAX calls. And your Web API will communicate with the database by using Entity Framework or Dapper or ADO.NET. Okay, so tomorrow, today just it is a demo class. I just introduced what is WCF, and tomorrow onwards we'll start the coding and basics, architecture and everything. Now you can ask any questions. I'll clarify your doubts. Please unmute and you can ask. Because still some interviews, they're focusing on WCF. Just basics, we'll learn WCF and then we'll shift to Web API. There we'll discuss about REST controller, front controller, JSON, consuming the APIs, gateways, yeah. All this stuff we'll discuss.
Excuse me?
You can ask any doubts if you have.
Hello?
Yeah, your name.
Yeah, still my name is Khaled. Is it also required when I have my application connected to the mobile platform, any platform, it should be my database via web services?
Your application want to?
Yeah, my application, it will connect it via mobile. So
mobile, yes, definitely. Yeah. See, your application is... See, in olden days, what happened, you know, see what I'm telling, yet try to understand one point. If I'm, this is my database, okay? This is my server, okay? Nah? This is my application. See, in olden days, you develop the application. For example, if you develop an application, ASP.NET, okay? Nah? Or ASP.NET MVC. You develop the application by using ASP.NET or ASP.NET MVC. This application can be accessible only through what? Browser. Only through what? Browser. Later, your client is asking, I want to make my application to run even in where? Even in where? Mobile. Then this application is nowhere helpful. Again, you have to develop the application by using some Xamarin forms. Are you following? Or by using some Angular, some other stuff is required, or iOS, etc. So what separate logic is required to develop every time. So instead of that, what you can do, nowadays, what is the current trend, you know? This is your database. This is your what? Backend application. This is which application? Backend application developed by using Web API. And this is your front-end application. Your front-end application may be ASP.NET, or ASP.NET MVC, or your front-end application may be mobile, means it can be developed by using Xamarin Forms if you are a .NET developer, or it may be some iOS, or it may be some Android, okay, nah? Or it may be some Angular. Now, no need to develop this particular backend application several times. Just to create, most of these backend application will write some database connectivity code and business logic code. It will communicate with the database, get the data, and provide services to different types of applications. Same application. Same application accessibility by using different clients. Now in this scenario, you can ask me, sir, where is the banking services? Separately, again, banking people also will create what? This is banking. They will create some other APIs. Are you following? This is your application. Your application also, you are using what? Web API. Banking people also will create what? Some APIs. And these APIs given by banking will be consumed by backend application. So everywhere web APIs are there, common everywhere. In olden days, you will never use this WCF. In olden days, the style is just consuming the services in olden web application architecture. But current trend web application architecture is that within the application also APIs are there. Third parties are also using APIs. Now you ask your question. You can ask your question, I will clarify. You can unmute and ask.
Hello, I'm Ram sir.
Yep.
Where you can use WCF in real time?
In real time, that's what I told you, no? To consume the third party services, to transfer the data from two different applications wants to communicate with each other. If your application wants to get the data from any third party, the third party, they will create some services. And as a developer, you must know how to consume that particular services. If you take one application, that application is getting the data from other resources. In that scenarios, that third party application is developed by using WCF and your application is web application. Your web application must consume that particular services. Okay. So I will tell you how to create the service, what is SOAP services, architecture of SOA, service oriented architecture, serialization, deserialization, everything I will cover. Tomorrow onwards, we'll start the regular classes. Okay. Shall I leave? Tomorrow, shall we continue?
What is the difference between web service and WCF?
Web service does not support RESTful nature. Some differences is there. Coding environment will change. It will not support REST APIs. WCF supports some REST API. Okay. Web services will not. Nowadays, web services are outdated. Even if you want to create the web service also, that option is not available in your Visual Studio Editor. Nowadays only, WCF is only there.
So okay. WCF is the advanced version of web services?
Yeah, obviously. Initially, in olden days, some 2010 like that, you have web services will be there. Later, nowadays, even you cannot see that option also. WCF also hidden actually. Inside somewhere, if you can manually search, you can create the WCF. Web API is hotcake in the market. First, web services. Next level is what? WCF. Next level is web APIs. Lot of differences are there. Coding environment is different. Some security issues are improved security, improved exception handling. All this stuff is there. Some contracts, all this stuff was introduced in WCF.
Thank you.
MVC Core plus Angular 7000 is the phase. MVC Core with Angular 7000. Only Angular 5000, only MVC Core 5000. If you join as a package, you'll get for 7000. Okay. That's it. Tomorrow we'll continue. Tomorrow we'll start the sessions. Yeah, obviously, instead of WCF, web API is only hotcake. But some basic knowledge is required on WCF, like serialization, endpoints, okay, some exception handling, some attributes, some contracts, some security mechanism, message exchange patterns in WCF. Some topics, one week like that, we'll refresh. And then we'll go for web API. Okay, na? Okay, hello.
Yeah.
I'm not able to audible. Sorry. Can you repeat? Or type in the chat box. I can read the message. I'm unable to hear.
Sir, myself Alok.
Yes.
Yeah, are you able to order?
Yep.
Yeah, sir. So just yes. I joined actually before 1 minute I joined at your meeting. So, of course, you are talking about sir, like the core, ASP.NET Core, and Azure, and all. So, can you brief?
ASP.NET Core and Angular. This is actually WCF free batch is going on. .NET developer, if you want to learn ASP.NET MVC with Angular, you can attend. Similarly, ASP.NET Core with Angular also you can attend. Okay, na? There are new batches are there. Wednesday, I'm starting new ASP.NET MVC. Morning, 8:30 a.m. Angular, 10:30 a.m. Okay, na? Two batches are there. ASP.NET MVC is 8:30 a.m. IST. Angular is 10:30 a.m. IST. Okay. I am only teaching. If you want to get the batch details, just you can go to satyatech.com website. Here you can go satyatech.com. There you can see online schedules. Satyatech.com. There you can see online schedules will be there. Just if you click there, you can see my new batches will be there, MVC. Here you can see this is your free WCF and just MVC here you can see. Just you can click this link, register now, and you can give your details. Your basic details you can give, your name, phone number, email ID, etc. And you can check your Gmail. You will get the link. With that link, you can join. Similarly, Angular 10 is also there. New batch is started. My batch. 9th September, 10:30 a.m. Register now. Click this link. So MVC with Angular, you will get some offer. Or .NET Core, it will take some time, more time to start. Just 1 week like that. Then you can attend for .NET Core also. Core mostly morning. Morning or evening we'll have .NET Core. Okay, thank you. Tomorrow we'll continue. Have a nice day. Bye. Today's class is there in YouTube Live. Go to satyatech.com YouTube channel and there you can find WCF. Okay, now? Thank you. Have a nice day.